Greetings dear friends, I present to your attention the most common malfunctions and breakdowns that occur on the Mazda CX-7. Theoretically, Mazda CX-7 comes with manual transmission, but we didn't sell complete sets with mechanics in our country and in the USA, and these cars were not brought from Europe when handles were. So it is simply not realistic to meet versions with a diesel engine and manual transmission. There are two transmission options, all-wheel drive with automatic transmission IC TF81SC and front-wheel drive with automatic transmission FS5AEL. Four-wheel drive is quite simple here, with a bevel gear and a simple electric clutch in the rear axle drive. No Holtex clutch or something more complex is required for the machine, however everything works quite reliably. True, then, until the car doesn't go to start bathing in reservoir and abuse of trips through the mud. In the event of jerks when starting on a slippery surface, it is usually enough to sort out the clutch. Cleaning the clutch pack from dirt and oil residues, and in especially advanced cases, replacing the oil seals and bearings. It is unlikely that it will be possible to break the rear gearbox. The clutch here serves as a good fuzz, even with serious tuning of the engine and the automatic transmission is set up quite conservatively. So if you do not install shift keys, then there is little chance of them damaging something. The reliability of the CV joints and shaft is quite acceptable, and when buying, you just need to check the integrity of the covers and the absence of extraneous sounds from the propeller shaft, the intermediate support of which can lose oil even with runs up to 70,000 km. This will happen due to the constant overheating that occurs due to the tight gaskets of the exhaust system and the hot temper of the engine. The situation can be aggravated by the installation of a long crankcase protection and poor condition of the lambda sensors. The same factors lead to leaks in the bevel gear, and it is worth keeping an eye on the oil level every couple of MOT. And of course, don't forget to change it every 50,000 km. The 6-speed automatic transmission of the ICTF81SC series is well known for Volvo, Opel, Ford, and a whole bunch of other cars. The moderately conservative design has practically no weak points in the mechanical part, but with frequent use of the sliding blocking, the blocking linings of the gas turbine engine are easily worn out here. In practice, this means that starts with the pedal in the floor box are contraindicated. One can expect rapid oil contamination. Well, with a regular repetition of this situation, you can kill the box with dirty oil with a relatively low mileage. The linings are demolished by the adhesive layer. Before that, it is better not to bring the open the gas turbine engine for preventing replacement of linings. It is not so expensive, about 5-10,000 rubles for the procedure itself and another 5-7,000 for removing and installing the automatic transmission. Fortunately, the automatic transmission control system tries to avoid dangerous modes for itself, so there will be no problems with twitching on a cold one, as it happens, for example, on Mercedes 722.6 and 722.9, or ZF 6HP. But even ordinary oil contamination should be not allowed. Icing valve bodies traditionally tolerate it very poorly. Despite the fact that the valve bodies of this box withstand starts in frost or overheating much better than the predecessors of the TF60SS and AW5551 series, they are still difficult to diagnose and repair. Factory and dealer repair only means replacing the valve body assembly, which is not at all humane in price. But there are repair solenoids for sale, all body requiring additional automatic transmission adjustment after their installation. With prolonged operation on contaminated oil, the material of the plate itself wears out over time, after which even these solenoids will not work normally. There are Zonex kits to repair the plate, but they require accuracy and very high quality work to prepare the installation site. And it's not surprising that successful repair of the very seriously worn valve body is rare in our country. The only reliable alternative to the new valve body is a factory remanufactured valve body. Unfortunately, this is not done in Russia and the restored part will also cost a lot. A faulty valve body, even when operating with clean oil, can damage the mechanical part of the automatic transmission. Fortunately, the box's adaptability margin is very good, and if you notice problem in time, change the oil, put in external filter, lower the operating temperature and watch for contamination, then the chances of driving will remain good for a long time. For those who do not want surprises at all, we can advise you to change the oil as often as possible, for example every 20-30,000 km, if the automatic transmission lubrication system has no modifications. For example, experienced Volvo owners advise changing the oil in the box once a year. It's not that expensive and almost guarantees that nothing happens to the box, even with heavy use. Another specific problem with the box is related to the cooling system. As well as on the hoses of the power steering and the fuel system, there are very weak spring clamps, and the rolling of the tubes is not very reliable. As a result, in cold weather, the oil from the box can simply leak out. After installing, an alternative automatic transmission appeared on cars. This time, on production of Ford Mazda FS5AEL series. This automatic transmission is very similar to the time-tested 4-speed FN4AEL gearbox. They have exactly the same main valve bodies and even gearbox from rear to forth. But on the 5-speed FS5E, EL, another planetary gear is added at the output with its own valve body. Due to the relatively small age of cars on the Mazda CX-7, difficulties with wear of the rear cover, Teflon rings, output splines of the main shaft, brake band, and other age-related diseases are still rare. But a very common problem is the breakdown of the forward planetary gear. Either the 2.5-liter engine turned out to be too powerful for this automatic transmission, or the quality of the Japanese assembly is not good enough. But at the planetary gear, it breaks off the welding at the junction of the body and the output gear ring. It is quite difficult to repair. The assembly accuracy is high, the thermal deformations after welding can interfere with normal operation. The price of a new or remanufactured part is in the range of 9 to 12,000 rubles. The surest symptom of such a breakdown is the loss of reverse gear. The second most popular reason for the breakdown of this automatic transmission is the wear of the rear cover, more precisely its caliper, the drum seats and the Teflon hydraulic seals. With an increase in torque, the load on the rear cover increases, with an increase in load, wear increases, and then oil pressure leaks in the seals. At some point, the oil pressure transmitted to the pistons of the friction packs or the reverse drums ceases to be enough for the normal operation of the box and they burn out. In the event of the weakening of the brake band, jerks are possible when engaging the second and fourth gears. Its tension can be adjusted by replacing the tension bolt on the box body and even without disassembling the later. The bolt must be changed to a longer one by measuring the original one. And if you only the first gear is turned on with the stroke, then most likely the pressure leak in the hydraulic cylinder of the brake band is to blame, which is usually associated with the slip of the direct drive and the simultaneous overheating of the band. A nice feature of this automatic transmission model is that almost all major problems can be eliminated without removing the box from the car. You can remove the rear cover, replace it, put on a new brake band, remove the hydraulic unit, remove the forward and the reverse drum, with all the feeling right on the machine. Sure, when performing work in such a condition, there is a risk of contamination, therefore they still try to go high quality and service repairs with the complete removal of the box. However, if you change the oil on time and do not allow overheating with runs up to 120-150,000 km, you are only threatened with the breakdown of the planetary gear, and we recommend that on the same run remove the back cover and then replace the Teflon rings to prevent more expensive troubles. The total resource of the automatic transmission before overhaul is usually at least 300-350,000 km. By the way, due to the cheapness of the spare parts and ease of disassembly, the repair of this box is one of the cheapest, so do not let the rather voluminous list of possible troubles bother you. Engines on the Russian Mazda CX-7 belong to the Mazda L family, which is often called the MZR. This is essentially not true, since MZR is a generic term for all Mazda engines of this generation. There are two engine options, a 2.3-liter turbo engine of the L3 VDT series or an atmospheric 2.5-liter L5 VE series. A diesel engine with a volume of 2.2 liters is practically not represented in Russia, but in constructive terms, it is a development of the same unit. Engines in this family are familiar to all fans of Ford, Mazda, Volvo, and JLR cars. In the past 20 years, these engines with a volume of 1.8 and 2.2 liters have been installed on a whole bunch of models. Structurally, the motor is extremely simple and inexpensive. An aluminum block with cast iron sleeves, an aluminum cylinder head, a timing chain drive chain of the oil pump in the crankcase, and the most technologically advanced design. Engines with a volume of 2.3 and 2.5 liters have phase shifters, and the 2.3-liter engine also has direct injection with turbocharging. In principle, atmospheric versions of the engine have established themselves as reliable and inexpensive to operate, although they require regular attention to attachments. Even the moderately forced versions of Ford's EcoBoost 2.0 turn out to be quite resourceful. The 2.5-liter engine, like its less voluminous relatives, boasts an agreeable character and a decent resource, but with the 2.3 DISI turbo engine, the situation is somewhat different. With it, there is more trouble and there are real problems in the mechanics. Let's still talk about everything in order. The engines of the CX-7 do not have any major layout problems. With the sufficient tie packing, there is room for repairs and if necessary to get the motor up. Of the serious problems of all engines, weak connections to the fuel line under the hood and a 2.3-liter engine sometimes has a pressure sensors on the injection pump. Fires in the engine compartment unfortunately are not such a rare situation on the CX-7. Therefore, if you smell gasoline, you need to check everything at once and eliminate all unproductivities. Another weak point was the laying of electrical harnesses. The wiring of the injector heats up and over time the insulation of the wires in this bundle becomes fragile, which leads to unstable motor operation and difficulties during repairs. The wiring to the lambda sensors in 2.3-liter engines even caused a recall, but this measure didn't stop the breakdown of the connectors and the short circuits in the harness. In general, Mazda has a very bad attitude to prolonged downtime of the street and washing the engine compartment. On cars of the first years of production, the cooling system can become a serious headache for owners. Added size, overheating, leaks and failure of not only the radiator but also the pipes of the cooling system are possible. All this is complicated by two more factors: an increased tendency to contamination of the main radiator and the risk of damaging the plastic housing of the thermostat and breakage of the thermal element fastening inside it. Previously there were thermostats in the metal case, but now it is problematic to purchase such. You have to change the usual plastic one every 2 or 3 years and choose an option from a good brand. On a 2.3-liter engine, it is better to install a low-temperature thermostat at 82 degrees, for example L33TX15-17O or equivalent. Motors with a volume of 2.5 liters do quite well with standard thermostat at 88-92 degrees, but with a low temperature, the resource of the thermostat itself and radiators will be higher. But installing an 88 or 92 degree thermostat on a 2.3-liter engine can lead to detonation. The oil heat exchanger on Mazda L engines is a common and well-known problem. Over time, its gasket will surely leak, especially if you drive a cold engine. And if you do not change the antifreeze on time, then corrosion and the ingress of antifreeze into the oil is possible. It is imperative to check it and the slight suspicion of the malfunction to sort it out. An oil leak in this unit can leave the motor without lubrication in a matter of minutes. It is not necessary to disconnect the heat exchanger and install the bracket from old motors without it. The oil will be permanently overheated, which will worsen the operation of the already overloaded crankshaft liners. In addition to the general complexities of the entire line of engines, the 2.5-liter engine is characterized by breakdowns of the intake geometry, change valves and weak crankcase ventilation system. Sure, these malfunctions are still extremely rare, but according to the experience of operating similar engines on other machines, one can expect frequent leaks in 3 or 4 gears. With poor maintenance, damper breakdowns, contamination of the intake manifold and air leaks due to poor fixation of the magnesium liners, simple design of fittings and poor quality plastic tubes and tubes. For now, you can just enjoy a very good motor option. True, it will not have a spark, but its resource is very good and even the chains with sensible maintenance are able to cover more than 200,000 km and his appetite is more than modest for such a machine. The turbocharged 2.3-liter engine is completely different, despite the generality of the design. That with the European firmware for 260 horses under the 98th gasoline, that with the Russian-American under 95th, the engine is precisely asked to fill in the 98th. And better the 100th or even 105th gasoline. What direct injection motors are not prone to detonation, tell that to Mazda engineers. You won't be able to hear the ringing, but in case of overheating or overblowing, it is easy to get broken pistons or even a hole in the block. If you fill in the 92nd, there will be no thrust and the chances of breaking the piston one increase to very high. One serious press on the gas after warming up and you can say goodbye to the engine. The control system is quite conservative and clearly not inclined to save fuel on money. On 98 gasoline, a perfectly serviced engine can even please with the acceptable economy, but its vocation is different. It is highly tunable and can live a short but flamboyant life with a maximum output of over 350 horsepower. But carrying a heavy crossover is clearly not its vocation. The first problem for the motor was the sensitivity to oil pressure. The BWK-04 turbines dies at the slightest drop in oil pressure, and this can be facilitated by poor arrangement of the oil supply and ray pipes. They are located in the hot zone and intensely coke after 3 to 5 years of operation. It is recommended to change or clean them every 30-40,000 run. It is advisable to use an oil that is more resistant than the original with a viscosity of at least SAE40. Crankshaft liners also suffer from a lack of pressure, but they last much longer. After hundreds of thousands of runs, it is recommended that they be preventively replaced out of harm's way. A collapsed crankshaft at 80,000 is quite a typical problem for MPS and CX-7 in the hands of a rider. Of course, if you miss the oil level, the consequences will immediately be dire. Even banal overheating of the oil will cause scuffing of the crankshaft and death of the turbine, or you can ruin the cylinder head. The camshaft beds are also very sensitive to oil deterioration. It is recommended to change the chains and phase shifters on a 2.3-liter motor without waiting for a strong knock to appear when starting on a cold one, especially if the motor is operated in combat mode. In this case, especially on forced motors, the first replacement of chains is best done with a mileage of less than 50,000. Then the stars of the places will remain intact, as well as the tensioners, and will be able to work with the new chain for another 50,000. But closer to 100,000, the chain will have to be changed for sure, but already together with the phase shifter, which in addition to wear of the sprocket will also greatly lose pressure, so necessary for the camshaft and the turbine. The reliability of the injection pump is quite acceptable, but closer to 200,000 mileage, the pressure sensor will almost certainly flow, the one that spits gasoline and doesn't change separately. This will cause the operating pressure to drop. This usually means not very cheap repairing the sensors or installing a new one. The injectors are strong, and if you change the fuel filter in time, they will not fail. The gas pump in the tank works quite reliably, but there are also enough replacements. Inexpensive Masuma, AEM, or Velpro stand out without changing the bulb. Or you can stick in the most stress and reliable Bosch 44, but only if the master is not afraid to work with these hands. But the original pump is sensitively expensive. The turbine on the Mazda CX-7 has a small resource, but this is a solvable problem and not even too expensive. The price of the Hitachi cartridge is about 20,000 rubles and replacements cost no more than 10,000. The reason for turbine breakdowns lies not only in the oil pressure and its choice. Even with the best oil, a large volume of blow-up biogases gets into the intake and actively pollutes it. The motor oil trap is simple and not very efficient, but the problem is compounded by the low reliability of the PCV valve. It changes separately from the oil trap, but it is best to replace the original part with something stronger and secure it with a check valve to avoid overflowing from the throttling space. A proven way to modernize that system is to install a genuine oil trap with a reliable check valve and an additional sump in the branch pipe that comes out in front of the turbine. This reduces valve coking, improves intercooler performance, reduces the risk of detonation, and increases the turbine resource. This motor has a good oil appetite. A large flow of greenhouse gases and a load on the ventilation system can result in an oil consumption of up to half a liter per 1,000 km. With runs over 100,000, rings often coke and valve oil seals need to be replaced. The character of the motor is hot, the cylinder head warms up well under load, and because of the high load, the cylinder head gasket often suffers. Another unpleasant moment can manifest itself during repairs. As you understand, the cylinder head on these motors is removed a little more often than usual, and the load on the both is higher than on the other motors in this series. And the thread in the block doesn't withstand. Even the obligatory installation of the new bolts with each cylinder head removal doesn't help. In the case of forcing the engine, it will be necessary to install new studs for attaching the block head and the new connecting rod bolts. The resource of the catalyst on the car with a 2.3-liter engine is also not great. Even with minimal oil consumption by the engine, after 1,500 mileage, it will almost certainly be clogged with deposits or even begin to dust. Please be sure to check its condition before purchasing, or at least availability. When buying a car with such a complicated engine, we advise you not only to make a test drive and check the cold start, but also to measure the compression, check the engine for leaks from under the cylinder head gasket, fuel leaks, the condition of the catalyst, the turbine, and listen carefully to the operation of the engine. And if possible, it is worth doing endoscopy, which will reveal the consequences of overheating and overload, traces of piston sticking, and valve cracks. In the future, it is better to forget about cheap regular oils and oil change every 15,000. Only high-quality synthetics better with a higher content of ester viscosity as AE40 and higher. And it is better to change it during urban operation every 80,000 km, and we strongly recommend installing either a turbo timer or an additional electric pump for cooling the turbine, as well as regular cleaning of the radiators and improved crankcase ventilation system, and just a lot of care and attention. And this information about the problems of Mazda CX-7 is exhausted. If you know more or disagree with what you heard, I'm waiting for you in the comments.